We define sustainability as everything we need to ensure that we survive long into the future. And that includes money, so profits. That includes people, human resources, our main raw material. It includes our physical raw material, which is cotton or polymers. It includes energy. It includes water. It includes waste. It includes chemicals. So these two businesses have been incubated at Urban for maybe the last decade or so. So the Advanced Materials Division was born when we were trying to see how we can build a next generation business using our core competence of textiles. So we started exploring, you know, various options, and then we zeroed in on advanced materials and particularly on three types of areas that we chose to focus on. One is human protection, where we produce solutions for protecting human life through fabric technology. So flame retardant, cut protection, high visibility, molten metal splash protection, electric arc protection, all kinds of fabrics and garments that would protect human beings in hazardous situations. The other vertical is advanced composites, where we are using reinforcement fabrics and resins through various processes to be able to produce products for building and construction, for mass transport, for sports like rackets and hockey sticks, for industrial purposes. So that's a very exciting phase and very exciting product category and application set. And the third group is industrial applications, where predominantly we are focusing on filtration of gases, filtration of liquids. So that's how the advanced materials came up. And water was born, the water business was born out of our own need to manage our water consumption better. And we were one of the first companies around to use recycling technologies to reduce our water footprint. We found that others were faced with similar problems, and we started consulting. Then from consulting, it went to equipment sale. From equipment sale, it went on to solutions. And then from solutions, it went to innovation. So our glass fabrics business is a joint venture with a German company called the Price Daimler Group. Glass is very important because it has the same strength as steel at a much reduced weight. So for applications where strength and weight restrictions combine, it is the ideal solution. So these can be $1 million ideas. It's just a question of how fast we can get there. And we're working with, you know, the purpose of making them large, profitable, sustainable, and, you know, benefiting society. Now, so they're growing at very high rates of growth. So if this, so, you know, currently advanced materials is at around 800 crores. The water business is slightly smaller, few hundred crores, but both growing at 30% plus growth rates. So we'll get there. So, and we do three concepts. We do Better Cotton. We are an implementation partner where we run projects in India working closely with farmers to make their cotton farming more sustainable, and hopefully also to transfer a lot of benefits to the farming community. We also do organic in areas where soils are poor and you can afford to completely eliminate, you know, chemical inputs. Organic farming can be, you know, very sustainable from an environmental perspective and very profitable for the farmer. So our focus is to grow at a good sustainable pace. Our focus is to improve the bottom line. Our focus is to reduce risk and debt. Our focus is to position the business for higher growth and profitability, which means investing in the right product categories, bringing in innovation, bringing in supply chain strengths, working on our costs.
Arvind, if you see, has been working on water recycling since late 90s. So over the years, we developed a lot of our own technological solutions and innovations. So we set up a company called Arvind Envisol, which is specifically looking at end-to-end water management solution, including water recycling. So essentially, we are looking at two different measures for avoiding use of fresh water. One is that we have a water recycling plant or zero liquid discharge plants within the facility, which recycles 100% of the effluent which we generate, and we are able to reuse back in the process. Second approach, which we have tried out for last few years and is very innovative and is in a public-private partnership, is where we use the sewage water generated by the communities around our facilities and bring it to our factory, install a sewage treatment plant to treat it and use it in our production processes. Fashion for Good is trying to help startups world over, which are looking at reducing the environmental and social impact of textile and apparel production. So right now, because of initiatives like wind power, solar, as well as biomass, we are able to reach about 20%. And solar has been a particularly great success in last few years as the technology becomes more and more advanced, as well as more economically viable. Our key challenge right now lies in further growth of renewable energy. So journey up to 20% was not easy, but we still managed to achieve it. But to take it to from 20 to 40 and further will be a challenge, and we are looking at solving that in the coming years. And other key thing we are looking at in the medium term is waterless dyeing space, where we want to expand waterless dyeing from denim to other categories also. I think an increased transparency would help. So traceability and transparency of the products, on how products are made, how these are sourced, would really help in educating customers on different aspects of production. And also promotion of sustainable textiles. So textiles made with sustainable cotton or recycled materials by the brands would also help in creating a newer market. I think the key part is the involvement of entire supply chain. So right from, if you see, agriculture commodity producers to manufacturers at different stages, to brands as well as end consumer, all of us have a role to play in terms of making the industry more sustainable. So I think all of us have a role to play in the entire value chain of the textile industry to make it more sustainable.